Are you serious? Are you serious? Grab a cup of coffee. We're going to read from Deuteronomy chapter 31. The word of the Lord from Deuteronomy chapter 31. I'll be reading from the King James Version of the Bible. And Moses went and spake these words unto all of Israel. And he said unto them, I am 120 years old this day. I can no more go out and come in. Also the Lord has said unto me that thou shalt not go over this Jordan. Speaking of the Jordan River. The Lord thy God, he will go over before thee, and he will destroy these nations from before thee, and thou shalt possess them. And Joshua, he shall go over before thee, as the Lord has said. And the Lord shall do unto them as he did to Sihon and to Og, kings of the Amorites, and unto the land of them whom he destroyed. And the Lord shall give them up before your face, and ye may do unto them according unto all the commandments which I have commanded you. Be strong and of good courage. Fear not, nor be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he it is that doth go with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. And Moses called unto Joshua and said unto him in the sight of all of Israel, Be strong and of a good courage, for thou must go with his people into the land which the Lord has sworn unto their fathers to give them, and thou shalt cause them to inherit it. And the Lord, he it is that doth go before thee. He will be with thee. He will not fail thee, neither forsake thee. Fear not, neither be dismayed. And Moses wrote this law and delivered it unto the priests, the sons of Levi, which bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord, and unto all the elders of Israel. And Moses commanded them, saying, At the end of every 7 years, in the solemnity of the year of release, in the feast of tabernacles, when all Israel has come to appear before the Lord thy God in the place which he shall choose, thou shalt read this law before all of Israel in their hearing. Gather the people together, men and women and children, and thy stranger that is within thy gates, that they may hear, that they may learn, and fear the Lord your God, and observe to do all the works of this law. And then you can continue reading the rest of the chapter, but certainly the law we're talking about here was the law given to Moses on Mount Sinai, or what we a lot of times refer to, the Ten Commandments. But certainly in this passage of Scripture, Moses is 120, and he's reached an age that God has already said man cannot pass. And so Joshua will have to take the children of Israel across Jordan River into Canaan to fight against these very, very large Nephilim giants that are among many tribes, not only the Amorites, the Amaleks, the Jebusites, the Hittites, the Hivites, the Canaanites, the Philistines. You name them, they were just all there. Giants. They were as much as 13, 14 foot tall. Even Joshua and Caleb said that they looked like grasshoppers compared to these giants. They were warriors. They were brutal. And these tribes were just about impossible, as if you looked at it from a physical standpoint, for how in the world were this ragtag generation of Israelites who have been wandering in the desert for 40 years, how in the world were they going to cross Jordan and defeat these people? It would have to be by simply the power of God. It would have to be simply based on the covenant with God that God had made with Abraham. And so against all odds, they moved across Jordan to take the land. But they were instructed to follow the law of God. And because of that, the land became theirs by faith. And that faith in God's word is what makes a difference in my life and your life. If you're saved, it's because you accepted Jesus Christ or Yeshua by faith. For by grace are you saved through faith. It's not in ourselves. It's a gift of God, not of works, at least any man should boast. You cannot defeat the enemies of darkness alone. Satan and his demonic forces are much greater than we are. But greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. Through the power of Jesus Christ, we are saved. God bless.